In simple Keynesian model, we consider private investment as autonomous. And also in simple Keynesian model, we don't make any, consider any interaction of commodity and money markets. But in reality, we have to consider the money market. And in reality, private investment is not an autonomous variable. Rather, it is more realistic to say that private investment, it is a function of the rate of interest. And we derive it from, you can explain it in two different ways. Number one, if we consider the marginal efficiency of capital, from there we can find that private investment is inversely related to the rate of interest. Or in simpler form, we can say that whenever people are, any investor is going to invest, it has to take loan. So rate of interest will determine the volume of the future liability of the present loan. So higher the rate of interest, lower will be the borrowing and lower will be the private investment. So we can write that I dash is less than zero. Next, if we consider how the income is disposed of, what are the components of aggregate demand, we see that one identity is that Y equals to C plus I plus G in a closed economy with government intervention. And how the income is disposed of, that is Y equals to C plus S plus T. So from here we can get that C plus I plus G, this is the another equality, the another identity, C plus I plus G equals to C plus S plus T. So if we dismiss these two, we can find that I plus G equals to S plus P. And if we further consider that the government budget is balanced, that means G equals to government expenditure is exactly equal to the tax revenue, then we can find that I will be equal to S. So private investment, which is a function of rate of interest, and savings, which is a function of income, this will give us the equilibrium condition in the commodity market. And from here we can find out the famous IS equation. So if we consider savings, savings is a function of Y and private investment is a function of rate of interest. This S dash is greater than 0, I dash is less than 0. Or in other words, we can find out directly if we consider S equals to SY. If we consider that from the other part of the equilibrium, we can directly go to the Y equals to A plus BY plus IR plus G. So this is the equilibrium condition in the product market. The left hand side indicates the supply side and right hand side indicates the demand side. So from this equation, we can derive the famous IS curve. So what is IS curve? IS curve is the locus of different combinations of income or Y and rate of interest that maintain the commodity market equilibrium. So IS curve represents the relationship between rate of interest and R and Y that maintain the commodity market equilibrium. So this is the commodity market equilibrium condition. So if we differentiate it, what we'll get? Okay. We'll differentiate it the other way. We write that A plus BY plus IR plus G equals to Y. So if we differentiate it, what we'll get? b into dy plus I dash dr equals to dy, or I dash dr equals to dy into 1 minus b. So we can write dr by dy equals to 1 minus b divided by I dash. So this is the slope of the IS curve. So if we draw the IS curve, it will be like this, r and y. So why this, what is the logic behind the negative inverse relationship? The logic lies in the relationship between rate of interest and aggregate demand. So we can write that if rate of interest falls, private investment will rise. So it is a part of aggregate demand. So aggregate demand will rise, output will rise. So this is the inverse relationship. So higher value of R gives you lower value of Y and R1, Y1. Second thing. So this is less than 0. Why? Because B is less than 1. We know that from the Keynesian consumption function, we know that the value of B, which lies between 0 and 1. And second thing, I dash is negative. So we can write that if we consider, forget about the direction, we can forget, only consider the volume of it. So we can see that if I dash rises, dr, the volume of dr by dy will decline. That means higher the volume, higher the interest sensitivity of private investment, higher will be the, sorry, flatter will be the IS curve. That means if private investment is highly sensitive to the rate of interest, what will happen? Then if there is small decline in rate of interest, will cause a huge rise in private investment and consequently a huge rise in aggregate demand. Just and vice versa. That means if there is the interest investment is highly interest insensitive, that means we can show you with the help of a diagram. Let us consider two cases, two IS curve. This is one IS curve and this is another. So this is I1, I2. So in case of I1, you see, there is decline in rate of interest from R0 to R1. So the aggregate demand will rise Y1 to Y11. But as per the, if rate of interest will highly sensitive, there will be high rise in aggregate demand. There will be high rise in aggregate demand due to small decline in rate of interest. So we have to remember that higher the interest sensitivity of private investment, flatter will be the IS curve, and lower the interest sensitivity of private investment, IS curve will be steeper. Next thing is, so we can write that slope of IS curve is value of slope of inversely related to interest sensitivity of private investment. And that means high interest sensitivity flatter IS curve, and low interest sensitivity steeper IS curve. Next thing is the shift of IS curve. So shift of IS curve takes place due to change in any of the exogenous variables. So if we consider the IS equation as y equals to a plus b into y minus t, we consider here tax also, plus IR plus G. So IS curve can shift outside, outward, if there is an increase in a autonomous consumption, if there is an increase in government expenditure, or if there is any decrease in taxation. In all the cases, we will see that given the rate of interest, aggregate demand will rise. So IS curve will shift rightward automatically. If there is any decline in A is an injection, G is an injection, T is a leakage. So if there is any decline in A or G, or there is any increase in T, the IS curve will shift leftward. That means given the rate of interest, at every level of rate of interest, the corresponding volume of Y will decline. Next, last point, any point outside the IS curve. So any point on the IS curve indicates the combination of rate of interest and Y that maintain the commodity market equilibrium. So any point at right or left of the IS curve means the disequilibrium in the commodity market. If we consider the right side, that means aggregate demand is less than aggregate supply, excess supply in the commodity market. And if we consider at the left side, excess demand in the commodity market. So if there is any point at the right side of the IS curve, there should be a decline in Y. Excess demand in the supply in the commodity market, so the producers will increase the inventory stock, and next time they will reduce the output. Similarly, if at the left side of the IS curve, excess demand, that means next time what to do? The producers have to deplete their inventory stock, and next time they have to increase their production. And any point on the IS curve means commodity market is in equilibrium.